just happened. Did you feel that? Yes!
How long did you practice for, Rob? Because you were good. You were really good.
Rob Thomas would leave later that day, but the musicians who came together to gig with him would go on to form their own band, Cool Boys and the Frontman. With the core members of Hamish, Andy and Jack playing one song per gig, they'd rotate their front person for every show, Conrad Sewell.
And they could never tear us apart.
The Veronicas. Guy Sebastian and Shannon Knoll.
How's the beer inside? It's been about 3 to 5 minutes.
They were at the top of their game. Then, a long hiatus, no gigs, no practice, no band. Until this.
We would like to get a Cool Boys and the Frontman private jet. 131060, do you have a jet?
And this week, the Cool Boys were back, flying around the country and New Zealand, playing one song per night. Queen's We Are the Champions. This week, they've rocked harder than ever before with Ricky Lee Coulter, Flight of the Conchords, Brett McKenzie, and Jessica Mowboy.
Get ready for an absolute earthquake of rock and roll.
Absolutely.
Today, they're joined on stage by Vance Joy to rock out one last time in front of their biggest audience ever.
I love you so much!
We cross now to Melbourne Park's Margaret Court Arena with Hamish and Andy and 6,000 screaming rock fans.
Hands up front, everyone! And Andy, driving you home one last time. Guys, how you feeling, Melbourne? This is exciting.
This is ridiculous. This is ridiculous. Guys, welcome, welcome. You scrimped and saved all year for your $10. You paid it. Now you're here.
You lined up. No, it was online. Guys, thank you so much. To paint the picture for everyone around the globe, if you're streaming, which is unlikely.
That would be huge.
That would be huge. To Obama, if you're listening, unlikely. We are sitting in front of about 6,000 people, brave the rain, in our first arena show, Ham, small stadium.
Our first indoor small stadium gig we've ever done. I see a lot of high-vis vests, smart merchandise buying. We see some life jackets because a lot of people kayaked here because it is raining quite heavily in Melbourne. It's an incredible show, obviously. This is the last Hamish and Andy radio show for the foreseeable future, and you are part of it, and thank you for being here with us. It's something... I mean, we've got so much to get through today. We've got Peking Duk.
Yep.
Guy Sebastian's going to be singing "See Not Love." It's going to be crazy. Then, of course, we'll have to go off stage and see if we can find Cool Boys and the Frontman.
Yeah.
But before we do this, I don't want to get it too bogged down, Ando, emotional stuff. But a lot of people might remember a couple of months ago, like a month or two ago, we had Macklemore on the show, and he was talking about he does a lot of stuff with Ryan Lewis, his buddy. And when they stopped for a little while, Ryan Lewis did something incredible. He got Macklemore a framed piece of the carpet of the first studio they recorded in.
Yes, that's right.
And I would like to give to you, Andy, a framed, plaqued piece of the carpet of the first ever studio we recorded
in. This isn't the carpet. Under no circumstances is the carpet. I remember how shitty the original studio was.
Sharp
and that's like a nice wool.
Sharp eyes, my friend. Sharp eyes. This is the best lookalike I could find. I only thought of it yesterday. And then so you can't get into the old building. It's gone. The studio's gone.
Yeah.
But what a seemingly beautiful gesture.
Yeah, it's seemingly beautiful, but it's not beautiful.
But let's... All right. How about this? Let's move on to a really beautiful gesture. Earlier in the year, I got the company mail.
Sorry, am I expected to keep this?
Well, do you have anything for me?
I've got nothing for you, no.
Well, then I guess no.
But I still think this is more of a nuisance than giving you nothing.
Oh, my final upset Andy of the year.
All right. Well, earlier we do it.
We got something fun to do. We want to start with this. We've got what started as another beautiful gesture by me earlier in the year, purchasing
a terrible financial decision. Hamish had many throughout our career. We have a joint account, if people don't know, but we do have a joint account. Hamish never asks permission and spends out of it all the time.
6815 is our PIN.
And don't
abuse that.
You,
as trust.
You announced to me at the start of this year that you'd bought 3,000 Hamish Nandy branded teaspoons. I don't know why there's any whooping going on.
This is.
I sent 1,000 back to the manufacturers that they smelted down. That was at a loss.
Look at this.
And now we have, I think, about 1,000 left.
Ladies and gentlemen. Here at Margaret Court Arena and listening around Australia, if you'll indulge us, could we finish this year and the radio with a teaspoon blitz?
Wooden spoon. That's a nice pasta. Grin spoon. Can you give my lips up, please? Front spoon. That feels nice. Back spoon. This feels nice. You can have any spoon, but what about a teaspoon? Hey, spoonatics, do you love stirring? I certainly do. Get ready for an elevator PQRS teaspoon blitz.
All right.
As the first teaspoons fly out into Margaret Court Arena.
Okay, that's not safe. 13.
They do have a heavy protective shell, as a few of you just felt on your head.
13-10-60. This is the way the blitz works, Ham. Is people call up wherever they are around the country, and they can win the teaspoon blitz.
Limited edition Hamish and Andy teaspoons. Call now.
Yes, a lot of other radio shows would give away, say, tickets to Pink or Coldplay or something that.
We don't have them.
But we do have teaspoons. Throw the spoons, people are chanting. There's actually one placard that says teaspoon. Okay, we'll go to a song.
The only time in history that this stadium has had the chant, throw the spoon. Throw that spoon.
It's Hamish Daddy driving you home. final show from Margaret Court Arena.
Mayhem.
There's some well, you're causing the mayhem.
I've never felt so powerful in my whole life. I'm throwing Hamish and Andy branded teaspoons out left, right, and centre.
Yeah.
Crazy. People are getting hit in the head. They're loving it. I don't know what's going on.
We do have a surplus because Hamish, misguided Hamish.
You try and gauge the market. Sometimes supply and demand is very hard to gauge.
I didn't think there was ever going to be a demand for 2,000 Hamish and Andy branded teaspoons.
Let's hear it if you love stirring.
All right.
Friggin' love stirring, man.
We've got some stirring enthusiasts in the crowd. Who would have thought?
Got some real fans of people that don't like finishing their instant coffee and having the sludge at the bottom. Now you've got to stir it.
Do you want to fire up for the last time?
For the last time.
We haven't had a blitz for a long, long time.
Let's end the year on a bang. Let's do a teaspoon blitz.
Wooden spoon. That's a nice pasta. Grin spoon. Hey, can you get the lips up, please? Front spoon. That feels nice. Back spoon. This feels nice. You can have any spoon, but what about a teaspoon? Hey, spoonatics, do you love stirring? I certainly do. Get ready for an LMNOPQRS teaspoon blitz. Blitz.
131060 is the number around the country. 131060. Sarah, kick it off for us.
Hey, Sarah.
I really like a teaspoon.
Hey, Sarah. You got that spoon!
Boom, shake, 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 free spoons. Boom, shake, 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 free spoons. Free spoons.
Thank you, Sarah. Andy just patting me on the back here for another great song here live on stage.
Yep.
Hey, Thomas, ahoy.
I need a teaspoon.
How come?
To go with my matching Hamish and Andy fragrance. Oh, Andy by Hamish, sorry.
Hey, Thomas, you got that spoon, boy.
Spoon for free. Spoon for free. Spoon for free. Spoon for free. You grabbed the phone, you caught us up, and now you've got cutlery.
Okay.
Hey, Ebony.
Are they all that long?
No, some are shorter. Ebony.
Good.
Ebony.
Yes.
Ahoy.
Ahoy, boys. It would be the best Christmas present ever if I could please have a spoon.
Is it a present for you or for a loved one?
Oh, no, for me.
You got that spoon, Ebony!
Yay!
I reward selfishness.
Then you got a free spoon. Sweet, sweet teaspoon. Enjoy your stirring.
Jordan, 131060. Ahoy, Jordan. Welcome to the final show.
Ahoy, boys. I've been waiting for this day my whole life.
So have we.
That teaspoon, baby.
Since you asked so forcefully, you got that spoon, Jordan.
It's a marvelous night for a spoon dance. And you've got that spoon in your hand. Enjoy your spoon.
Okay, can we one more, Tom?
Okay, one more. I'll randomly select from the computer. Amanda, ahoy.
Ahoy.
Amanda, I'm just checking if we have any spoons left. I think we got one. Would you like that spoon, Amanda?
I would love a spoon.
How much do you love stirring?
A lot. Like at least a 9 out of 10. Oh,
wow, that's high.
Amanda, you got that spoon. You got that spoon!
I don't think... You know how that song goes.
Smooth operator.
I know, but it doesn't sound like that. Like
spoon operator. Yeah,
I know
the person
what you're
with the spoon.
I know that what you're trying to do. The melody just wasn't matching smooth operator.
The boy who could feel music. Sometimes the original artist did it wrong.
Stick around, everybody. I've got to go to a break here. But every cool band, which is us, Cool Boys and the Frontman, needs a support band, someone to emotionally support them. That's what we understand supporting does.
True.
Peking Duk, fresh off winning Song of the Year at the ARIA Awards on Tuesday night.
They are here.
They're going to join us straight after this. Hamish and Andy.
To stay connected to the Hamish and Andy show, just keep your radio.
driving you home. For the last time from Margaret Court Arena and our cool boys in the front, man, Private Jet 2, a hand thanking Mazda 3, be in the driver's seat. And will you please welcome to the stage, everybody, fresh off winning Song of the Year at the Arias, our support band, Peking Duk.
Ducks.
Hey, Ruben.
Yes. Welcome. Welcome, boys. Hop up onto your vocal mics. Don't be freaked out.
How are we doing?
Yeah, we're doing really
well. How's everybody doing out there?
Peking Duk.
First of all, make some noise for these lads. This is an amazing party.
And Michaela, who here is going to be the front person, they're similar to our band. They have a rotating front person.
Two cool boys and a front person. I love it.
Yeah. Guys, first of all, Song of the Year at the Arias on Tuesday night.
Congrats.
Thank you.
It must be amazing for that to be the second coolest thing you've done this week.
I know.
It's now, hard to, this is to way cooler, 100%.
Is it true you're gambling that aria on today's performance?
We actually are. Who told you that?
We really are. Whoever wins out of us gets the aria.
I must say that...
Clowns.
I must say that... As cool boys and from in our band, we're intimidated by your stage presence.
Yeah, you're good.
You guys bring it. And at the Arias, Adam, you had a firework going off the end of your guitar.
Yeah, it was a bit of a danger hazard at the end of the day because...
They're the worst when
we
hazards.
They're bad. Because when we did the actual rehearsal with the firework...
It was hilarious.
The string players weren't behind me.
That's what I thought, because I was watching it and you seemed remarkably close to the violinists that were behind you.
Yeah.
Not really noticing them because you were taking in the crowd... And you were flicking sparks back at them, holding their wooden instruments.
It was bad.
Yeah.
They were almost set on fire, 100%.
Yeah, I thought so.
The worst part was, I actually couldn't see how far they were behind me because I had fireworks everywhere.
Yeah.
So I was just sort of like, oh, well, and I started laughing.
Yeah.
Which would have been terrible.
It off. Yeah, it would have been really bad if I was laughing and they got burned.
Quick tip, don't spray fireworks out the end of your guitar.
I noticed that your firework list today, that's fine. I'm also doing that with my guitar. We're not going to strap fireworks to it because it's cheap.
It's not a competition.
And it will probably burn.
Andy's, yours is plastic too, so yeah, that's super dangerous.
Guys.
I mean, a support should never try outdo the main act.
No, that's true. Guys, take it away. We're going to hear the new single. Now, before we do hear Song of the Year, guys, Peking Duk, of course, Let You Down is the song.
Thank you, boys.
Thank you for being here.
Make some noise for Hamish and Andy.
Don't know him. While we're at home, I'm getting high in bed. You should. some noise for Michaela Barron.
So good.
Hats off Friday. Hamish Daddy driving her home around the country. Peking Duck performing live at Margaret Cordelina. Well done. Well done.
So good. So good, Michaela. First of all, as we've been touring all week, obviously, as a band.
Pooped.
You guys just played the length of our whole set that we normally play, and you've still got one more song to go, which is crazy see that sort of stamina.
Yeah.
But also, the stage presence. I mean, I don't know where Cackling Jack is. I know he's side of stage. Jack, I don't know if you've got a microphone, but...
Yeah!
I mean...
Jack, any chance
did
you can
you
bring...
see?
Yeah, that's the kind of stuff I'm going to do today.
Wow. What a coincidence.
Finally. Finally, we're going to see it. It'd be nice. Guys, you are the support band for Cool Boys and the Frontman, and as we understand it, support bands come in and emotionally support
the
main
act. Yeah, totally.
So we're wondering, I mean, maybe starting with Jack, do you have a compliment for him leading in to his gig a little later on?
That's a pretty cool hat, man.
I was about to say, nice hat.
Oh, no. No, that's great.
That's great. He's up and about there. That's
well,
fantastic.
You've opened a can of worms because that's a Yamaha hat.
That is my guitar sponsor, Yamaha.
Oh, thank you.
There's been some contention in the band that Jack
sold out. I'm
sure
they're our drum sponsor or something. It's fine.
True. All right, well, that's a lovely... That's
is that the slow guitar that plays slower than anything?
I've got that fixed up. It's very fast now.
Okay. Sick.
Okay. He's a speed demon now. He's Van Halen.
Now it's too fast.
Jack actually plays with thick woolen gloves on to slow his hands down because the guitar's too fast now.
For me on keitar, Ruben, on keitar, what would any comments?
You're the most impressive keitar player I've ever seen. I've never seen someone do it with two hands.
Huge!
This guy!
Yeah, have you seen that?
Jeez, that's nice. That's really lovely, guys.
Ando,
that's how you stand.
Yeah, that's so unexpected for you guys to say that's really that's lovely. Good.
Man, you've got to understand, these guys would have seen 4, 5, maybe 6 keitar players in their lives. And for you to top that list, that's the huge. Best.
That's great,
Ruben. My favourite keitar player.
Oh, thanks, Ruben. Okay, I feel supported. Ham, on
so
the
much
drums.
To pick from. So much to pick from. Do you focus on my vocals? Do you focus on my playing?
I love the way you keep the rhythm going.
That is all drummers, but thank you. Okay.
It's good.
Finally,
we should say, have you got something for Vance? I mean, Vance Joy is going to come out and he's going to be performing.
Who's excited for Vance?
Yeah. Woo!
Do you have a compliment for him?
Yeah. We need a compliment for Vance?
Well, he's part of the band, so you guys
he's
got
our front man.
Got to support him as well.
He's got better curls than I do.
That's very good.
He's got very nice curls.
Guys, we can't thank you enough for being here. You got one more song for us. Just so happens to be Song of the Year.
I mean, are you getting sick of hearing that year, or is it just sinking in?
Yes. Congratulations.
Making me nervous now.
Guys, we just want to say on a personal note too, thank you so much for all the fun we've had with you guys over the year. Yep. From Streaking Duck to everything else we've done, it has been a ball. So thank you
for having us. We love
you. Cheers, boys.
Thank you, boys.
Take it away.
Thank you.
Shout outs to the Cool Dogs.
Make some noise up the back there now. And on the right-hand side, make some noise. All right.
your hands in the air, everybody. Stranger, could you walk me home?
So much.
Thank you.
Peking Duck, everybody.
Peking Duck.
Congratulations, as Glitter reigns on Margaret Cordelina. Thank you so much.
Unbelievable. It was like.
Also, got a shout out Joel Farland on the drums right here.
Great job, Joel. From a sticks man, one sticks man to another.
What up, buddy.
It was like a Snapchat filter in real life. It was incredible. I can't describe it.
Hamish had your back, Joel, if you went down as well. He was going to take the stage. Sorry about that. Guys, got to go to a break on the other side of this. We want to give everybody out there, wherever they're listening across Australia, a chance to harness the power of a crowd.
This crowd's incredible.
So we're going to need your help. It's after this. Hamish Nandy, driving you home for the last time. Peking Duck, everyone!
If you're ever caught up in the fun of the Hamish and Andy Show.
driving you home for the last time from Margaret Court Arena. 6,000 strong crowd in front of us, Ham. Thanking Groupon, our official tour partner, keeping us in the air. Groupon.com.au.
And thanking Emidio's House of Spoons. I just had to get that away.
For the teaspoons. Giveaway? Okay, no probs. Hey, people around the country listening at the moment, we want to get, I mean, we're riding high on the fact that there's so many people here. We saw how the crowd picked Peking Duk. Lifted them to new heights.
That was
well done to you guys.
You know, Peking Duk, not a notoriously low energy act, but you did lift them to another level.
Yes, and we were thinking, how can we give the people show out there a chance to harness a 6,000 strong crowd? So we thought, if you're out there on 13, if you're out there on 13 1060, for instance, in my life, for instance, what are you doing, bud?
Sorry, I'm just scratching my own face on the giant screen behind me. Sorry.
But how's that helping everybody around?
Well, I mean, just for the people listening, that's you do the talking. I was just having a moment scratching my head.
Anyway, on 13 1060, what we're going to ask is, if there's something you haven't done, might be around the house, might be at work, might be to do with the kids.
Classic day to do it to, December 1st.
Exactly.
You know, you're trying to get the stuff done for the year.
For mine, it would be, I've got an esky at home for a party 2 weeks ago that's just got warm water in it now and beer's floating in
it. Sure. We all know that. We've all been there. Guys.
I need to go and put them back in the fridge.
But you don't want to, but you need help, don't you?
I would need help. I'd need 6,000 people yelling at me saying I could do it.
Do you want us to try?
Well, no, because I'm not at home.
Yeah, but I mean, could it fire you up now to go straight home and do it?
Oh, okay. So just as a, I suppose, a demo.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, my gosh. I should leave immediately.
Please don't. Please. But it worked.
It does work. So 13 1060, what have you got happening in your life out there that you need a little extra encouragement? Our crowd will cheer you to get it done on the other side of this song.
Just heard someone yell really enthusiastically, put them in the fridge. It's working.
That's what we need. It's Hamish and Andy. Mazda 3, be in the driver's seat. And Haim, on 13.10.60, we've got 6,000 people here at Margaret Court Arena, enthusiastic.
Big time.
And they can lift you to a greater height if you're performing in front of them. So we're asking, have you been lethargic about something out there?
Yeah. Have you got something that you need to get done and you've been sitting around all day going, I could do it if I had 6,000 people cheering down the telephone at me?
Yes.
Well, guess what? We're the radio show for you today.
Gus, ahoy to you, Gus.
G'day, boys. How are we?
Yeah, we're very good, mate. Very good. What have you got that's on your plate that's too much? Can't be achieved unless you have 6,000 people.
First of all, just a shout out to my mate Darcy, who's in the stadium at the moment. Happy birthday, Ando.
Oh, but, actually, don't celebrate him.
He does. He certainly does, Gus. And thank you for taking the load off my plate.
Okay, well, very good. Well, I'm still losing at the moment. And I have to clean my room, and I do not want to do it.
Right.
Beer bottles everywhere. I'm terrible.
Hey, and did you say you're on schoolies at the moment?
Yeah, schoolies.
And you're.
Thanks for listening.
But hang on.
Great choice.
I mean, obviously, it's 6 o'clock, you know, you put your disco shirt on and then you head out.
Yeah.
But now you're just warming up. So you're having schoolies at home?
No, he said he's in a hotel room.
Are you in your hotel room?
I'm in the hotel room.
Oh, that makes more sense. All right. I'm with you, Gus. I think you said you had to clean out your bedroom. I've just been having schoolies at home.
No. Beer bottles everywhere in his hotel room.
Yeah, no, come on. You're not going to get your bond back.
Do you want to get it done, Gus, before you head out tonight?
I've got to leave early tomorrow, so I don't want to do it tonight. I don't want to do it tomorrow morning.
Yeah, fair enough.
Put the phone right up to your ear, Gus. Yep. We're going to count the crowd in. They're going to cheer for you to clean up that schoolies room. Yep. All right, here we go, Tiger. Three,
two, one.
I mean, Gus, you got to do it.
I can feel it, yeah. I'm feeling good.
It's worked. Thank you, Gus.
Thanks, Gus. Apologies for me thinking you're having schoolies at home.
From Gus to Michael. Ahoy to you, Michael.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy,
happy
Mikey. Good man.
They don't know me. Michael, what's on your plate that you need to clean up?
I've got a kitchen sink full of dishes that need to be done.
Right.
Jesus. Just lacking the motivation.
This is really being utilised for tidying this segment.
Yeah.
Okay, Mikey.
Do you want something? Is there a specific pot that's hard to clean?
The old man made pizzas last night.
Yep.
They're real hard to clean off.
Cheese bake on
a pizza dish. Well, hopefully the crowd can incorporate some good luck with the cheese baked on in the dish type chat.
Well, it's going to be messy, but here we go. 3, 2, 1.
How's that feeling, Mike?
I clearly saw...
Yeah, look,
Yeah, consider them washed. Oh, that's great. That's
good.
I clearly lip-read someone going, good luck with the cheese. Which I'm going to add to throw me that teaspoon is another weird thing that you would never hear normally at an arena.
Yes. Michael, it's done. Ahoy, Andrew.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Andrew.
Andrew on 13.10.60. Welcome to the People Show. Mate, what do you need to clear off the slate?
After a big week, a bit deflated, and I just reckon I'd like to hear the crowd sing happy birthday to Andy, followed up by...
We've run out of time, I'm afraid, Andrew. It's nice, but I'm afraid you're going to... No, I'm afraid you're going to remain deflated. Turn the crowd mics down. Turn the crowd mics off.
Never seen such a reluctant happy birthday. Hooray! I mean, how do you feel there, Andrew?
That just made my weekend. Yeah.
You've ruined mine.
Did you just do that?
It was a trade-off. It was Andrew versus Andy. Yep.
I mean, did you just do that, Andrew, because your name's Andrew and you wanted to hear a crowd sing happy birthday, Andy?
No, I've got two boys actually at the Margaret Court Arena today, and they got on the radio when you did your...
Your sons are there, are here.
Yeah, they're there.
Is this your dad?
What are their names?
Brandon and Riley.
Brandon and Riley, are you around? Way too far
way
out.
Way up the back. Right out of teaspoon range. we've turned your cheer into a cheer for your sons, Andrew.
hey, Andrew, one of them's just taken its top off and is exposing himself.
I know Riley. He was the guy that was taken out at the start and put in the divvy van. Yeah, cool. No, they're having a good time. They're having a great time, man.
Thank you very much for calling. Cheers, Michael. Thank you, mate. Your sons over there. We've got to take a break because obviously people need to know the news.
Yeah.
That's why they tune into this show. We're just a mere, drippings on the side.
We're the run-up to the news.
But on the other side of this, guys, Guy Sebastian is going to join us for a very special performance. Hamish and Andy, we're driving you home. The unexpected. driver's seat. And Haim, I've had so much fun with this next artist over the years.
It's been epic, Ando. Pleasure. It's been a long, long, long journey.
Yes, and it's a pleasure to welcome to the stage Guy Sebastian, everybody.
There he is. Ando, I've gone down on one knee and I'm trying to high-five him.
Yeah, he's come behind
you. He's gone the other way.
Guy's on the stage. Guy, welcome, welcome, welcome. You'll remember the day, but you won't remember this particular moment. Okay. There's something that happened, I think the first time you probably ever met Hamish.
Right?
And I wasn't there.
Really?
Right. That's why I was crying so much and screaming, where's Andy?
So... people mightn't know this, but Hamish started on the radio working on a show, Tracy and Matt.
Yeah.
And Hamish was called Street Bitch.
We don't need to talk about that.
Street Bitch. He was the Street Bitch.
Back in those days, that was a term of respect.
You'll always be my Street Bitch.
And
I was 20 years old, guys.
As an assignment, he had to go up and interview the winner of the first Australian Idol.
Wow.
So Hamish, one of Hamish's first ever interviews...
4 years ago.
was interviewing you as a Street Bitch.
Chasing you down.
Maybe that was sort of what... people probably saw our rapport and went, he's a startup bloke. Give him a better gig.
You do 10 albums. Okay, you find an on-air partner, then meet back here in about 15 years.
Yes.
And sing on stage at Margaret Court Arena. And it's worked.
The perfect
circle. And we've done some pretty cool stuff in the past. Yeah, actually, my favourite ever radio thing I've ever done was the Guy Versus segment we did.
Yes.
Guy Versus the Playlist.
Again, people mightn't remember this, but Guy Versus the Playlist, where Guy started every single song for a show, it had to be the same tempo and the same melody, same key, and we merged those songs into the real one.
And we won an award for it, didn't we? Yeah. Well, you guys did. We didn't really do much.
Did we win a Grammy for that?
Sitting on your shelves, I never got one.
Hey,
I did the work.
Guy, set in stone, crazy good song, and obviously nominated for Song of the Year last week, the Arias.
Yes.
Peking Duk
did win
it.
Whatever.
Did you see them backstage?
Yeah.
Look, they're mates, so I'm glad it was them. They're good blokes. Cool. They deserve it. They've performed, right?
Yes.
How killer are Peking Duk? They're so good.
They're amazing.
So good.
Guy, Bloodstone's the new single. It's off the album Conscious. We want to hear that one first. We've been playing on the station. We bloody love it.
Sure.
Before we talk about another little chapter that we're going to issue.
Look, I was pushing for this song first, just so that it gets first impressions last.
Yeah, I think that's a smart play.
I didn't want to do the other song.
Yes, fair enough.
Sorry, just to clarify, you are doing the other song, aren't you?
Guy Sebastian, everybody, make him feel welcome. Bloodstone's the song. Hamish Natty driving you home.
Telling me that we should stay and fight. I know it's gonna take a lot to change your mind. Oh, but baby, put the white flag down. I'm rolling up my sleeves right now. Oh no, I'm not afraid to bleed. Work my hands to the bone. More words than I want you need. I let my labor show. Can't do there's more in this bloodstone. Oh, 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 oh. Let me hear you sing. Oh, 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 oh. There's a version of me I need to bring to life. I'm really not that asshole that I was last night. I tend to mess up every good thing in my life. Somehow, so let me get to work right now. Oh no, I'm not afraid to lead. Work my hands to the bone. More words than I want you to need. I let my labor show. Can't do it on my own. I need you to believe. So please, please, squeeze. Cause there's more in this bloodstone. I'm gonna show you, so let me get to work right now. I'm gonna show you, so let me get to work right now.
Sebastian, everybody! Woo-hoo-hoo! Hamish Andy driving you home. Phenomenal. Off the album Conscious. It's out now. Well done, buddy.
Thank you.
Guy, man, it has been so much fun. I mean, we've had you on the show all the time for the last 13 years.
I just remembered one thing, Ham. We started back on the radio, you know, just a little under 3 years ago, and you were firing me out of a cannon.
Yes. Yes, I was.
We came
I don't know if you guys remember the launch party, but to celebrate launching and the theory of launching and the concept of launching, I launched Andy into Sydney Harbour.
Landed on my back and bruised it.
Fine, guys. He's okay.
Can I tell you that the day before I arrived just to check out the cannon at the circus.
Yep.
And you and I bumped into each other because you were buying tickets to go to the circus.
Exactly. I had my little boy and we were actually going.
And you were in cricket whites and he'd just come from playing cricket.
I did, yes.
What is this other life you've got?
I know.
Man, on stage.
I'm a massive cricket nut. Like, yeah. Grew up playing grade cricket and AFL ambassador for the Adelaide Crows, yes.
Not getting too many
woos. Shut up!
We're literally like 500 metres from the MCG.
Well, it's nice to see the day before we returned and also on our last day here, Guy. Uh-huh. Something phenomenal happened.
Which is why we'd like to put you in cricket whites now and fire you out of a cannon.
I'm up for anything.
Something phenomenal happened about 3 or 4 weeks ago.
It did. And look, it struck Ando and I as, you know, incredible. As I say, you've been on the show. We've watched your talent grow and hone and get taken abroad as one of Australia's greatest artists. And, you know, it was a couple of weeks ago that Ando and I went, you know, we've watched Guy rise, his star rise, and he's ready.
Yep.
He's ready now to take on his biggest challenge, which was Andy and I, we tried to write a song in 10 minutes. I'm sure a lot of you are aware of it.
Yeah.
Coconut Love.
Yeah. And the idea was we give Guy 40 minutes to fix it,
20.
And then he, and they're 20.
20.
And then he had to go in and present it to the heads of the station and all the music directors of our entire network and try and pass it off as his own song.
There was no rules for what got included as a lyric. We were able to write this, so we wrote it in about 4 minutes. if it popped into our heads, it made it in. It's a powerful song.
Yes, since then, Ham, primary schools out there have been singing it at their end-of-year school concerts. I think this is the Lloyd Street
this
primary
is our favorite.
School, if you haven't heard this one.
Listen to these kids.
We have the best listeners.
We
the fact that they were sending that in.
So,
Guy, we are thrilled that you said yes to perform it one last time.
Now, Guy, we know that this song, you didn't ask for this song to be written. You didn't ask for it to be given to you. We picked the music. Mm. We picked the lyrics. You just had to use all the tricks available to you to make it great. But it's grown on you, hasn't it? And you love it so much. I'm going to turn off this iPad so you don't have the lyrics. Because I know it's meant so much to you. Yes. You know it off by heart.
Well, you know how some songs just flow.
Yes.
And you get into it and you get lost in the song and you don't have to think about the lyrics.
Yes.
Let's just go through this.
This is not one of those songs, is it?
This is not one of those.
Take a sip with me, baby, from these two halves. Girl, you've been skipping. Damn, they're wild. They're well-defined calves. They say a bounty also really satisfies.
Because of coconut.
So why not try a C-nut with this guy? There's no
it
flow to
rolls
those.
Off the tongue. Rolls off the tongue. Hey, Guy.
That's why the lyrics are in front of me.
We promised you that if you sung it one last time for the adoring crowd here as well as Australia, you can wipe this clean of your history.
This is it.
Are you ready to flush Coconut Love from the toilet of your repertoire?
Let's do it. All right.
Take it
are
away, buddy.
Let's do a Coconut Love with Guy Sebastian.
Oh, we got dancers. We've gone all out. Do we have pyros?
Do you got dancers?
We've got dancers.
Oh, fantastic.
Oh, my God. Would you please welcome the Coconut Love dancers?
Oh, wow.
Sing along. You know the words.
Tough skin, and if you what you threw on the inside. That's refreshing. Let me hear you sing. Love is a coconut. I feel it in my gut. If you're stranded and it's all you got, that's okay, cause love is a coconut. Love is a coconut. I feel it in my gut. If you're stranded and it's all you got, that's okay, cause love is a coconut. So take a sip with me, baby, from these two halves. Girl, you've been skipping, man, they're well-defined calves. They say a bounty really, really satisfies. So why not try a sea nut with this guy? Oh, yes! Love is a coconut. I feel it in my gut. If you're stranded and it's all you got, that's okay, cause love is a coconut. Love is a coconut. I feel it in my gut. If you're stranded and it's all you got, that's okay, cause love is a coconut. Oh, dear. Oh, no. Love is a coconut from the palm tree of life. Crack one open with me, baby, and be my wife. Maybe we'll have a son, maybe we'll have a daughter. Come swim with me in the coconut water. Yes, it is.
Changing lives, one song at a time.
Guy, can I just ask, before we put it to bed,
yeah.
And thank you to the Coconut Love Dancers.
Yes.
Lyrically,
mm-hmm.
How often does a song have the concept of, like, saying something and then going, but that's okay. but that's okay, because love is a coconut. It's
a lazy way to round off a thought, but it's...
But you know what?
But you nailed it. You nailed it. We've
just heard a bunch of kids singing this song, yep, and it's influencing a lot of children. I don't know whether it's for the good or for the bad.
I think it is. It's teaching kids survival skills, because you really can survive just off coconuts.
That
ask
is
the guys
true.
On Survivor.
What is in? What are the main things? Is it
you got high in fats? The coconut water's got a lot of potassium in it. We're not really here to talk about the nutritional value, but you will be able to survive off a coconut.
I will look it up. I'll Google it up later.
God, just like
thank
pub.
You. Thank you again. Thank you, everybody.
Hi, Sebastian.
An amazing sport. It's been so much fun. Stick around, everybody. The cool boys are not far away. It's Hamish Andy driving you home for the last time.
If you're ever caught up in the fun of the Hamish and Andy.
home for Mazda 3. Be in the driver's seat. And Ham, not long now till Cool Boys and the Frontman play their final gig. It's our final show. For wherever you are in the country, at Margaret Court Arena at the moment, 6,000 people celebrating this final show with us, Ham.
This whole thing was set up, Ando, so we could play an arena gig. And now looking out at the crowd, it really...
You're pooping yourself?
I'm not pooping myself at all because I never would, because I'm an excitement machine and I rise to the occasion. I'm just saying.
It just seems like you're nervous.
No, I'm mentally going through in my head what bits I have to do of the song. That's all.
Yeah.
It's just, I've seen my drum kit. It's occurred to me that we're playing today. It's just sinking in. However, this is unorthodox. Mm-hmm. We don't normally do this, Ando, before we have our gig, before we play our gig. But we'd like to bring out our front man for today.
Yes.
To welcome him, to say thank you for being here. Would you please welcome Vance Joy.
Vance Joy, everybody.
Bubby.
Bubby's here.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. What a year for you, Vance. What a year. I mean, Nation of Two's coming out next February, I understand.
Yeah.
Lay It On Me is the single we've heard. It's actually one of Jack's favourite songs. I don't know whether he was sucking up, but it was before he knew you were the front man.
Oh, amazing.
It's been over in the States. You've played a few arenas so far. In fact, I came and saw you at this very stage. How's the nerves for your own gigs versus this one?
I'm pretty nervous, but how's the vibe in here is amazing. It's like party time, so...
You would think we have a smoke machine in here, but it's just steam on people.
What's been the most surreal moment over the last year for you? I mean, this picking up in the States and playing your own shows has been phenomenal.
Yeah, surreal moments. I've got to meet lots of lovely people and I guess people that I've admired. And
Who was top?
Yeah, give us.
I
top
met.
Two.
You're allowed.
You can have two because then you don't have to feel weird about.
Well, I got to meet Taylor Swift because I opened for her, which was cool.
Ever heard of her, guys?
And I usually don't do this, but it's like, you got to tell some people. Yeah.
Tell 6,000.
So, yeah, but I was at a show in America.
So how did that come about? How does it come about where Taylor Swift goes, hey, we think we want the ex-football player from Australia to open for me?
I think she heard my song Riptide, and she did a cover. And, she, asked me to go on tour with her, and I was like, yeah, I'd love to do that. But it was...
Nino.
It was a big step up.
He should have not called back for 2 days.
Yeah.
and then who's number two? Who's in the
number two? I was at a show and my manager came up to me and said, Julia Roberts wants to meet you. And I was like, whoa, Julia Roberts?
Pretty
like
woman.
Old school. Yeah, pretty woman.
Wow. So, yeah. And did you decline or did you go and say good day?
I went and said hello.
What did you talk? What's the icebreaker with Julia Roberts?
She was very friendly and smiley and very warm.
Yes.
And I just was there and then... I was just ready to talk for as long as possible, and I got the vibe after a couple of sentences that it's time for you to leave.
Oh, yeah. Oh right, so you effectively got asked to a meet and greet with Julia Roberts.
Yeah, it was that. I was so how's and I was okay, yeah.
Okay, and off you went.
Well, Vance, I mean, we've had a lot of great history with you on the show. We went rollerblading together. I'll never forget that.
Yeah.
Slightly twisted my knee, actually. That day still niggles me a little bit. I'm not making an excuse for the drums later. I'm just saying.
Constantly, Vance, throughout this week, as we've toured around Australia and in one gig internationally for the Young Farmers Association in New Zealand, Hamish will constantly sit there and just fiddle in a little or just seed a few excuses for potentially not playing well later on.
I'm sorry, mate. I keep my bandmates informed. Think communication's a good part of a team.
Okay.
However, we've had an amazing journey with you, Vance. When we asked you to be the front man potentially for today for our biggest, easily the biggest Cool Boys and the Frontman gig of all time, We heard back, look, it's the only day in your whole schedule that you'd ask a year out from your management, hey, can I have that day off? Because it's Vance's birthday. It's your 30th
birthday. It's your 30th birthday.
Yeah.
Which is insane. Now, I've organised something. I've organised a little something. It's also Andy's birthday year.
No, make it about Vance this time.
It's Andy's birthday year. It's your birthday year.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
Would you guys join? Now you can choose to say Vance or Andy. I've got a cake that's about to come out. Can we please just have one last time on the show
a
rendition?
Thank you so much.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Vance. And to a lesser extent, Andy. Happy birthday to you.
Hip hip! Vance, there you go.
Thank you.
he didn't get it out of one breath. Well, no, he's got them all out.
He's saving his lungs for the song.
Vance, thank you so much for giving up the afternoon of your 30th birthday to come and share it with us, with everybody here and everyone around the country.
Now, Vance, the next time we see you, you'll be in full frontman mode.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
How different is it to this?
I think it won't be that much different.
Yeah, fair enough. Well, you can head off. I do any vocal aerobics you need to do to get into the mood.
Oh, hang on, one more thing. Just so you, I've got something for you to eat the cake with. A limited edition, almost one of a kind, Hamish and Andy branded teaspoon.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Love you guys. Thank you so much.
That's a pleasure. There's about 1,000 of them. Vance, happy birthday. We'll go to a song here.
He's heading out the back. He's going to do some stirring and measuring with the teaspoon. He's having the time of his life.
Stick around, everybody, because, yes, the cool boys are not far away. It's Hamish and Andy driving you home for the last time. And Haim, not long now. Obviously, for new listeners out there, what a strange time to
what
join.
What a show. But, what a show for you to join.
But if you've just, you know, discovered radio and switched it on for the very first time, welcome, by all means, welcome. But there's a hell of a backstory that we've created a bit of a montage for to really get everyone up to speed, a how-to guide.
We have.
For what is Cool Boys and the Frontman, our band hand, which we'll get to in a moment.
Obviously, Ando and I are just in our band casual outfits, which is the band uniform light windbreaker jacket. Andy's chosen to wear the trucker cap, still available. I see a lot of people
wearing the high visibility vest, which was a controversial piece of merchandise we marketed this year.
Yep, we make a loss on those.
We're not the worst seller, though. Not the worst seller.
I wish it was.
Okay, well, it split the band. However, it's been an incredible journey for the band to make it here to our first ever arena gig. As you can see, already the stage is getting ready for Cool Boys and the Frontman.
Yep.
The curtain has been set up that will hide our bass player, for he is to receive no accolades whatsoever.
There is only enough limelight for four people, and alas, he is the fifth.
I don't even like you looking at the curtain, so you want to check it out, just try and glance at it peripherally,
yeah.
And then obviously turn all the attention back to the other instruments.
Jack, obviously on lead guitar. Jacko, what kind of stage presence can we expect?
I did a successful spin on Wednesday night.
Yes.
Can I do that again?
Oh, sure. people may or may not know, but if you've got a keen eye and you're not looking at Vance but looking at Jack, he winds himself up in the cord. So then when he does the spin, he's free to move. It does restrict him for the first half of the song, but that's the price you have to pay if you want to include a spin. I think you go with it again, Jack.
I'll also throw in a kick for you.
Whoa! Ladies and gentlemen,
wow.
Where were you when Jack promised one kick and an otherwise solid performance as he stands rooted to the spot with his promotionally gifted to him guitar? All right.
Haim, we've had a hell of a week.
Crazy week.
Some huge gigs, playing obviously existing functions. If you don't know, we only play one song gigs and we only play functions that have an existing crowd. We made an exception today.
This is very rare that Cool Boys and the Frontman headline. Mm. It's huge for us. It's huge for us professionally. We've put together a little bit of a story of the week so far as Ando and I leave stage, and because obviously we can't play in our band casual outfits.
No.
We must play in full-on stage costume. Andy as a Top Gun pilot, Jack as a 1920s aviator, myself as a baggage handler. Mm. That takes time. If anyone is listening in the control booth, if we could be now lowered down on the hydraulic lift. Not working today. Okay, we're going to leave manually via the stairs.
Yes. But if you could all imagine that we're going down a hydraulic
lift,
cool. That'd be nice. And then we'll trick everybody in their cars. So heading down the hydraulic lift now.
Just cheer for the lift. Cheer for the lift.
Whoa, yeah,
oh,
wow.
They love the lift. And cue the montage.
These are the rules for being a true rock star on tour. Rule number one, always fly on a private jet.
I've actually never been on a private jet
swear
before.
Swear.
Oh, now pumped you
swear.
Up. Well, I have sweared 100 times, so I don't know why I'm worried about it. Yeah.
I've sweared 100 times.
Oh, what a legend. What a legend. I can't believe it.
That just
God,
gives you some idea.
Didn't know we had such a bad boy in the band.
Oh my gosh. I hope there's a cage in the jet so he can't get us. I hope it's like Con Air so we can lock him up and put a muzzle on him.
Oh, wow.
Rule number two. Point out the advantages of flying private at every opportunity.
Tell you what I love about this. I haven't met anyone from the public. This is so private.
It's nice to know every single person on board.
Yes.
Rule number three. When given the chance to steal a fellow bandmate's moment, such as Ricky Lee's epic finale, maybe don't.
Really looking forward to singing that last line, though. But
you stole the line.
No, I saw an opportunity.
You stole my moment, man.
Cannot believe you stole the lead singers.
I saw an opportunity and I took it.
Of all the rubbish we throw around in this band, I thought particularly that move you would apologise for, but you're not even
dog sure. Move. That was what we were classic. That's a dog move.
I'd like to say that I think double standard is being employed. It seems to be all well and good for the crowd to sing along in some bits, but when the drummer has to go.
Rule number four. If you take your bandmates on a social activity to attract a dealership in rural New Zealand, try not to get the giggles.
How many tractors do you move?
How many do you like us to move? Yeah.
No, how many tractors? So I'm trying to make these guys learn some stuff.
What's funny?
Where do we get them from?
Yeah, where do you get the tractors from?
Rule number five. When introducing your bandmates on stage, make sure you get their name right.
In the final chorus, I thought it might be a good time to introduce the band.
Oh, that's cool.
I might sit the guitar solo out and just play rhythm.
No, you gotta play. No, because I'm gonna say John, right?
Jack. I would say Jack.
That's one thing we don't have in common with Queen. Freddie would often know the members.
This is John, right?
Yeah, good enough for me.
Rule number six, don't poo on a private jet. Ever.
Code Brown, does anyone hear us? This is Cool Boys in the Frontman Airways. We have a biohazard situation. The air's hazy and stinks in here so much. You might as well have done it in your seat. We're now flying in the world's most expensive open sewer. Unbelievable.
Rule number seven. Just because you rocked out and did some spins at a Battle of the Bands with Jessica Mowboy. Doesn't mean you're going to win.
The winner's been announced. It wasn't us, it was Belle Rose.
I can't believe we've lost. Why didn't they wait for us to come out?
I'll never be in a Battle of the Bands again. I was sort of looking forward to the moment we're all holding hands backstage nervously waiting like Eurovision. We just got handed a phone. We just got handed a phone that said, hey, losers, you lost.
And the final rule for an epic band tour, always get tiny hand-drawn tattoos of your fellow bandmates' faces before your last gig.
Guess what, Ham? I'm in.
Yes!
He's the kicker. I'm not putting Jack on.
So that's it. After a week on the road, or more correctly, in the air, we've reached that moment. After this break, Vance Joy joins Cool Boys and the Frontman on stage for one final version of We Are the Champions. Don't go anywhere.
To stay connected.
been driving you home over the last hour and a bit, but right now, right around the country, are you ready for Hamish and Andy to rock you home? The thousands of people at Margaret Court Arena in Melbourne, please give it up for the band that you've been dying to see live in the flesh. This is Cool Boys and the Front Man.
We're called Cool Boys and the Front Man. And we're here to rock you for at least 2 minutes.
Melbourne, do you love rock more than anything? How's it going? We're Cool Boys and the Front Man.
We love your city.
This is a cool town. Love to get back here one day. Just flew in our private jet to Brisbane, and we had to hand it back. There was a higher paying client. Anyway, we have been on a private jet this week. We've been spreading the gift of rock all over this corner of the Asia-Pacific region.
Yep, and we support young farmers at home and abroad.
But ladies and gentlemen, there is nowhere else we would rather be than right here in Melbourne at Margaret Court Arena with you.
That sounded good, actually.
Thank you. That's good. I got one more thing that just popped in. I'm going to try it.
Yeah, go for it.
Earlier this week, we started as a group of misfits trying our best to play music.
Yeah.
But yesterday, we bonded with blood and ink. We now have tattoos of each other on our bodies. And with that sort of unity, we hope to bring you our greatest ever gig as we welcome our frontman for this afternoon. That doesn't sound as cool. For tonight, our frontman, would you please welcome my bubby, Vance Joy!
All right, guys.
Hope you like good music that's played together in time and perfectly.
I paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence. Made a
Good night, Melbourne. Vance Joy. Vance Joy, everybody. Woo! Hamish, Andy, drive you home. We'll be back shortly. Court Arena, high off the gig.
Huge gig, Ando.
I know what I did.
And massive gig. You all saw it. Andy, after being so vocal for my effort earlier in the week when I sung the last part of the song when Ricky Lee indicated to me, take it.
Yep.
Ando decided here to have a go today.
I just thought, renegade move. It was the tattoo. I think the tattoo is...
I don't know who he is now. I don't know who he is. He's got a tattoo. He's stealing the end of songs. But undeniably... a powerful finish. Vance Joy, an incredible front man.
Yeah, well, I apologise to Vance, but I just went with it.
He joined you, really.
Yeah.
So you both stole the car and drove it off together.
How did the Sia wig feel?
Sorry, yeah, I've got the world's first ever Sia mullet. so much is going on. I forgot to even mention that we'd broken a world record today and we've got a Sia mullet. Also, during my drum solo, I dropped my stick, but caught it in reverse and kept going. And I'm not sure... if that's ever been done before.
Probably has, but well done.
But guys.
It's time to just say a few thank yous before we get off your radios for good. We just wanted to firstly thank our amazing team. Our engineers, Andra and Gino.
Incredible.
Have got us broadcasting from some very strange places over the years. They hovered helicopters above our tall ship to beam the signal back. So we're indebted to you guys.
All these boxes, they have lugged them around the world, helping make our dreams come true. We absolutely couldn't do it without those guys.
Our producing team, of course, Sammy Cav, has been with us since day one. Day one.
Carly, Farah, Jack, Jez.
Carly resisted having a baby to be here today.
They're amazing. They can organise gigs in a rural New Zealand for us, which is to no mean
feat. Notoriously tough place to gig.
Exactly. To that station we've been with for 14 years, Haim 15 years. Thanks for your support, Grant Blackley, to Gemma and to Dave.
Grumpy Dave as well. The man that held the purse strings on so many of our adventures and was grumpy, but he was loose with the purse strings, and we thank him for that.
Haim, on a personal note?
Well, I mean, there's so many people we do need to thank. I probably need to give a shout out to Jack Spin. I think that was incredible.
Yeah. I didn't see the kick. How was the kick?
Kick was good, but the spin was better. Yeah. While we're here, Ando and I would like to acknowledge Jack. He, you know, even just in the last 3 years, he's become so much more part of the show, and we absolutely love it. So it's an honour. It's a pleasure. One of the sharpest, funniest guys. We're so lucky. We're so lucky that we get Jacko.
Web Geezer Jez has lost our Bitcoin password, so...
he knows what he did.
but he's so...
No harm, no foul. It's only $26,000 worth of Bitcoin at today's prices. But we don't check it every day.
But it's pales in comparison to the wonderful work you do, Jez.
Jez, you're worth 3 Bitcoins, and that's huge. Oh, look, on a personal note, obviously my family, my mum is here, the Savo, Cabo's here, but all my beautiful family... Moosey, my grandma, was a huge part of the radio show when we started. I'm sure she's listening today, so I love you, Moose. Friends, family, of course, that have been there with us through the journey. It's been a lot of times, a lot of things we couldn't be at, but it was, you know, it was always worth it, Frando and I, because we love doing the show more than anything else. But, you know, a lot of people in our lives made sacrifices and gave us the time to go on these adventures. None more so for me, of course, than my beautiful wife, Zoe, who is here. My queen, and I can see him in the crowd, my prince, my little sonny, my sonny boy. And because she has sensitive ears, my princess, Rudy, she is at home. but she's, you know, get off the internet, Rudy. She's probably streaming this and chatting to her friends on Facebook. I love you guys so much. I love you with all my heart, and I can't wait to see what the future holds with us. I was going to do that thing where you, like, footy players get to have the family on stage.
Yeah.
But it seems like it's a bit of an annoying walk. but so I look forward to the kids watching this back and me trying to somehow explain that this is what Uncle Andy and I did for a job when they were little. And I thank you. Thank you, guys.
Absolutely. I'd better thank your family as well. But to my pals that are all up there, my schoolmates, to Mum, Dad, my brother Cam, my sister Alex, who can't be here because she had a kid 2 days ago, but she is streaming this right now. And to my beautiful girlfriend Beck, you guys, all of you guys, make me laugh so much when I'm outside of the studio, and it's really easy to carry that kind of joy into on air, what I do with Haim. So a lot of the show I owe to you guys. You've been a part of the show, often unwillingly, because we've pranked you relentlessly. But thank you so much to my team over there. But the main people, well, Haim and I want to thank.
Before we get to that, Ando and I would like to sing I've Had the Time of My Life a cappella, and we'd like complete silence. But well, we are running out of time. That was scheduled. We're going to drop that for a more important item. But, I mean, this feels weird because Ando and I are about to do this together after the show. And then, of course, next year the podcast will still continue. It will be a weekly podcast.
So for our podcast audience, thank you, but also for our radio audience.
And Jack will, of course, be with us on the podcast. So the adventure, this for Ando and I, you know, it's certainly a station along the trip, but it's certainly not the end of the line. So we've got, you know, I love you, mate.
You too. For every
I got a you too. I got a you too. I'm glad I didn't just get a thanks. I know what it means to say that to someone.
But for everybody who has emailed from around the world this week saying how much they've enjoyed the show and how much they've lent on the show, often through times of trouble in their particular lives, and they felt it helped them, right back at you guys out there, you guys here and everybody listening, we've lent on you just as much over the last 10 years.
So much. And, you know...
There's a funny thing, and Ando and I have been together, this has happened to us personally, and people come up over the last couple of weeks as people, you know, the word sort of circulates, oh, you guys aren't doing the radio show for a while. You know, people will, so, I mean, I'm paraphrasing, but they'll say to us, you know, they'll say, you know, different stories, what the show means to them, and then I'll often say a version of the sentence like, oh, you know, but I'm sure you don't care because it's just like one person's opinion. But the point is, that's all we care about. Mm. Like, that's all we've ever cared about. So if you're one of those people, or it has touched you, it has had an impact, that is all we care about. So thank you guys, to the people here, to the people around Australia listening. That's the only reason. Otherwise, we just sit in a room by ourselves with no microphones. You're the reason we have the microphones in there, because we get to do this, and you let us have, you've given us our total fantasy. Mm. So thank you so much.
Thanks, guys.
Cheers. Have a great night. Classic double ending. Classic double ending. We said goodnight, and now we're back to do a photo. We're just going to try. We're going to try the thank you speech again. Put a few more jokes in. Okay, guys, here we go. Three. Please be in this piece of history. 3, 2, 1. And if you'll indulge us, can we just get our whole team out here? Would you please give a big round of applause to Sammy, Webgeezer Jez, Eliza, Carly, Marshy, Farah, Cackling Jack. This is such a weird ending. Please leave in an orderly fashion. Thanks, guys.